Okay, and I think we should be live. Hi all, welcome. Today a bit different stream as normal. We are going to unbox and do some testing with this ATEM Mini. It's a video switcher which has up to 4 inputs and you can use it to control your different cameras and PC, basically anything that has an HDMI port. So let's first open it. It is actually smaller as I expected. I expected a bit bigger box, but it is actually really small. So, I expected it like to be, for example, the same size as my Rodecaster, which is an audio mixer. And I don't think you can see it here on the small camera on the right for a bit. So I expected basically the same size, but it is actually much smaller. So that's really nice. We will be testing it with a camera, and probably my computer as well. Depends a bit how everything is going and if I can get it set up really easy during a stream. So let's switch over to this second camera and let's start unboxing. I haven't opened it yet at all, so I have no idea what's in here. So let's see how this is going. So the first thing we see is a nice welcome sheet. So that's really nice. It's a getting started, some information about the manual. I actually downloaded it already and did read it this afternoon, and some getting started. So I probably won't need it. It has some information about the software installer and what you need. So they are not sending a SD card or something like that, but just having the manual online. Okay, let me adjust. I hope this is better, 3D Print Creator. It was a bit hard earlier, so I did lower it a bit. Let me know if this is better. And yeah, download DaVinci Resolve for free. Oh yeah, it is already free, so. So the next thing we have is the power supply, and you actually get a full worldwide usable power supply. So that's really nice. Let's get it out. And this is the European one, so we need that, and the rest we don't need for now. And there we have the unit itself, so it looks really small. So let's get it out. So this is the unit. It is really small. And let me check if there's anything else in the box. Nope. So this is it already. So this is the unboxing. So this is the unit. You have basically 4 buttons here below to choose which camera you have. You can use a few audio buttons here above it, depending on what you want to use your audio with. I'm going to try and use my Rodecaster together with it. And I think that should work, so we will see that. You have here some, how is it called? Transitions. So let's try and power it on and see what's going on. They didn't include a USB cable, so that's a bit cheap, I guess. I did hope they would have included one, so we will probably need to find a USB cable. And I have no idea if I have a USB-C cable. So I expected a bit better that they would at least include, because you will need it to use it and to test it, I actually will need it. So we will need to find one. So let's first power it on and let's see what happens. So a bunch of buttons are already powered on. So that's nice. And let me see if I can at least add my preview. So it has one HDMI out, and you can use the USB cable for the webcam. So I'm going to put in my HDMI out to a monitor I have over there. And I am going to take this cable to a second camera I have there, so I at least can see something. I know you can't yet, but we will see. I will see if I can grab a USB-C cable to test this out. Okay, I'm back in a minute. Okay, I was very lucky and just found one on the floor in around me, so that's nice. So let's put on the USB-C cable and let's see if my computer is going to detect it. It does show up, so that's good. Hi Joe, 3D printing head. Okay, so it's trying to install it. So what we are going to do first is checking if it's going to work. So we are going to start the software and see if we are able to see the... So let me switch to the... Let me switch to the camera and let me start the ATEM software. So here, and I'm sorry for, let me not have my... So we first here have the ATEM Mini control panel. So let's see if we can set it up. You need to have an IP address. Let me put in my network cable over here as well, so we can use that. And then I need to check which IP it has. So I am using UniFi, but I need to check it on my phone, sorry, because I don't want to show that on screen. So give me a minute while I do this. It is not showing up yet. Ah, there it is. It's 10 to 40. Okay, so I got the IP, and it's actually the same IP as that was shown here, which is interesting. But that should work. Yes. For now, I will keep the rest of the settings the same. So now we can connect the ATEM software and that should detect. Yes, there we have it. So if we basically what we have now here is the same buttons as on the ATEM Mini. So we have the four camera buttons over here and all the rest of settings. So because I am using OBS right now, because I'm basically using both or wanting to use both my old camera setup as this new one, I do need to edit to OBS. Normally you can, because it is detected as webcam, you can use it directly as webcam within YouTube, depending on what you want, of course. So yes, German 3D printing net. It's around, I actually paid €350 but comparable to other switches, it actually is really cheap. Of course it is a lot of money, but I'm not using it only for this kind of videos for 3D printing, but also a lot of other stuff. So in my personal opinion, it is really worth it. Yeah, I paid, it depends on where you got it. I got it at Camera Express and they were $349, I think. I saw one store that had it a bit cheaper, but that last, not that cheap. So what I'm going to do is in OBS add the camera. So hopefully, and let me show you this as well. In OBS, we should have a new camera device. So let me see if it is detected. And there it is at Blackmagic. So, and there we have it. So we have now two cameras and they are, what you are seeing now is actually the Blackmagic Mini. So if I'm switching to this camera, it looks different. it are two complete different cameras, and I see I have the white balance on the second one completely off, but yes, or on the first one, I think. So what we can now do is, and I probably should grab a second camera. What I'm going to do is use my, I don't have three cameras, so I can't use the second one, or the first two cameras as well. But what I'm going to do is plug in my computer and use that as second monitor. So I need to configure that for a minute and say that I have two monitors, and the second one I want to use it as duplication. And this will trigger a bit here, yes. So if I'm now going to switch, because I should go to this one. So this is again the A10 Mini, and now if I press the button here, it should go to my computer. And it, because it has OBS open, it was a bit weird. What you also saw, and I will go back now, is you see that it has some nice transitions. So if I do the auto button, it should transition nicely to the screen, and if I press it back, it should go back. So that is one of the really nice features of this thing. So basically, it's really easy. Basically, it's just putting in the software or the HDMI cables, and it just works, and that's really nice. Another thing I want to try, and I have no idea if this is going to work, and let me see. I do need to turn it around a bit. It also has support for picture-in-picture, so what I want to do is try this. Yes, so what we now have, and it looks a bit weird. We have now in the right, we have the second camera. So this is completely done on the A10 Mini. So I didn't change any settings on my computer or anything. I just pressed the picture in picture to on, and that's it. And you can choose as default, it's now at the right below, but I also can hit right top. So you just change one setting here and it just switches. So that's really nice as well. And if you toggle to a different, or if you switch to a different output, it just removes the picture in picture. So yeah, setup is really, really easy. So basically we have done now 10 minutes within this stream and it is already working. Yes, the Elgato Stream Deck is exactly what I have here. I will need to do some modifications, because you actually have a piece of software that you can control this. So yes, that I already had that, and yeah, that is a really useful thing. What I want to try, because I am using the Stream Deck that's over here, or the Rodecaster for my sound, what I want to do is directly input the sound into the A10 Mini as well. Now I just have it directly into OBS, but that's not really handy. Yes, it is really easy to use. It's, yes, basically just plug and play, and I love it. That is really easy. Yeah, if you do a lot of streaming, I have no idea how much it actually is. I think I paid 200 euros or something for it like that, but I got it for a long time. Basically, they can 3D print creator. I have now still the Elgato, or do you mean Stream Deck, or do you mean my old Elgato card for capturing? Because by default, the Stream Deck, you can't use it, but I think there's an app for it. Let me look it up. Okay, yes, so let me show this here. So there is a app for it, and that's called Companion, and that has a that has support for the Elgato Stream Deck. And what it basically does is modifying what you see on your Stream Deck, and that has also support for the Elgato or from the Atom Mini, or basically all Blackmagic devices. So I have no idea where there is any documentation about it here. I haven't tried it myself, so I'm not exactly sure how it works. I will be trying it very soon. I think I saw in the past here documentation, but I can't find it anymore. Yes, but this is basically so you can use your Stream Deck together with, for example, Elgato software or the Stream Deck. Yes. So what I now want to do is try to put in my Rodecaster Pro to the. Yeah, there is a video on their site. I don't want to play it live because I have no idea what kind of music or something is in there, and I don't want a copyright strike on my channel. But yeah, I have seen a lot of videos, and it's made by, I think, a Swedish guy, and he is doing a lot of video recording and things like that. What I'm going to do is, I have connected the speaker output of my Rodecaster to a 3mm input, and that should work with the microphone or the line input here. So what we need to do is modify some settings within the Atom software control panel, so we can see that a bit as well. So let's try that out, and let's switch to the software. And what I'm going to do is insert the Rodecaster into the mic one, and I think you need to go here. And then let me see. So what you see here on mic one, we have already sound input, so that should work now. Let me check that I don't. Let me switch, sorry. Let me check that I don't have double sound now in OBS. Okay, so I don't see any sound here. Okay, yes. So of course I don't see any sound because I don't have it turned on yet. So when I'm going to turn it on here, I should be seeing sound coming into my Rodecaster. So what I'm going to do in OBS is temporarily disable my direct Rodecaster and see how it comes out of the Atom Mini. So let me switch back because otherwise we are getting stream. So did you guys still hear sound? I have no idea. I didn't see any sound on. Okay, so that didn't work. That is interesting because the Atom software control here did show here that we should have sound. So I'm not sure what's happening. It's probably an OBS thing because basically this should have direct sound. So this is something, yeah, probably not ideal to try on stream. So I will be doing this later on when yeah, when we are off stream. But basically, we get sound directly into the ATEM Mini. So that's really nice. I'm sure it is just OBS being weird as always. I didn't see any. I have had problems in the past with OBS and, for example, getting audio sounds directly. So what the great advantage is of having directly the audio sound within the ATEM Mini without you mean what is happening on channel on camera one here? On camera one is my sound from my camera directly, but I'm not using my camera sound. So there is sound coming in from there, but this is I'm not using it to stream. So that camera is actually turned off. The camera sound or my microphone or my cameras are really bad, so I'm not using them. I'm using just for that the Rodecaster, and that is now just put in into the separate USB port on my laptop or on my PC, and that is used into OBS. But I don't want to do that on a moment when I am streaming just at the ATEM Mini. Yeah, mic one did have sound, but it didn't show up on OBS. So when I put this on, it is showing here, and it is put on as output. But when you look here at OBS, at the video capture device, which is my my device for the ATEM Mini, it is not showing up at all. So it is probably just some OBS thing that is not seeing any sound. No, yeah, there is. It is not timecode. There is a bit of ruis. I'm not sure about the English name, but yeah, this is not a perfect microphone that's on there, and that's also partly from the microphone. And it might also be a really bad. Yeah, cable management now on my desk is really bad, but that is just partly also because I just wanted to switch during the stream. And this is not how my normal desk is actually, because normally this is my desk where I do my normal day job. So normally it's not like this. So yeah, I think that's it. I know it is a really short look, but I only have the availability to show two inputs right now. I do have in total three cameras. I need to get a third HDMI cable, but the store didn't have any of the right cables. So I need to get that on Monday. It should be there. And then I can use all three cameras I have plus my desktop or laptop as input. So that's really nice. And that's a really nice feature to have. For using, and I'm really looking forward for the upcoming streams I have, and I probably will have one on Monday or Tuesday with some electronic soldering, some really small components. So that will be my next stream, and I will definitely be using this device for that. So really looking forward to that. And yes, you can store a still in the machine. So let me show you that as well. So basically, and I didn't try that yet. Basically what you can do is go here to the media device. Let me see how I can try it. My desktop is a mess, and that's not good. This should be fine. So basically, I think you can just. So basically I now loaded this in here, and when I now click here on the switcher and say for example that when I want to go to media player one, it goes to that stream, so that picture we just loaded in. So basically that's how it works, and you can load up to 20 pictures and only stills, so you can't load any videos into there. So that's a disadvantage. I would have loved if you could have loaded in just some video, but for example for a starting stream still or something like that, that is really nice. And yeah, you can, I think you can load, yeah, you can load up to 20. You can also, what you also can do, and I don't have any lower thirds, but you can also use here, if you set the downstream key here to Media Player 1, and you have a transparent image with, for example, your name and things like that, you can use that as lower third as well. I don't have one here, so it's a bit hard to show directly now, but basically you create an image that's maximum full HD, because that's the resolution you can use with this device. And if you have it just your lower third, your name and things like that, you can use this to display that for example for 5 seconds or something like that. So that is also really nice. You can do really a lot with the software itself. Some of the basic stuff is you have keys in here, for example the transitions, how long a transition takes, what kind of transition you want. Now I'm using a mix, but you can also for example do this transition. Yes, this was a PNG file, but it probably has support for basically all images. But you can also do this as transition. You can do let it take 5 seconds in this transition, so that you have all buttons for that on the A10 Mini. If you want to do a bit more stuff, you need to get into the A10 software. You can also do green screen things like that. That is supported. I have not tried that yet. What I did read about this is that you need to do a bit more settings there. I think it's here the upstream keys and then your keys for the chroma. And I think now something died. Ah, I did put it on, sorry. I'm not sure how that happened. You can here choose your fill source and basically what color you want and all things like that. So that's all supported as well, and basically you need to have the software for that, also for sound support and all things like that. But all basic things is you just have for switching, setting sound on or off for a specific camera, can all be done on the device. Personally, I think the only thing I am sort of missing, I think, is a multi-view where you can see all cameras directly. The HDMI output that you have now can be set to 4 different things. A preview, and that's what I have, so I you basically see directly, I have a monitor there and I see directly what else also shown on OBS. You can have a program out, that's what I now have. You can have preview, and that's basically if you're using it where you can see the next scene. So if you when you then press a button, then it doesn't directly cut to the screen, but you first see what's going to happen, and you can use that. But what I wanted to see is a multi-view, so you can see all 4 inputs that are there directly, and then you can choose directly from that what you want to see. But to be honest, that is a nice to have feature, but yeah, not that much needed. So yeah, that's a very first look. It is a really great looking thing. It is really small, and as you can see there are now a bunch of cables in there, but it is really small. It is basically just the size of my hand in height and two hands in width. So it is really small. It is much smaller as I expected. So that's a really nice thing. And yes, I'm really looking forward to using this. And I think I'm going to have a lot of fun with it. So I probably, like I said, I will be using it on my very next stream, depending on when DHL is going to deliver stuff and other appointments I have. I will be doing that probably on Monday or Tuesday. So I look forward to that. So yeah, I might look into that. I also heard they might want to do a software update for this to support MultiView. But yeah, to be honest, my money is also gone for now for a while. So well, it wasn't that expensive. It's still a pretty expensive thing. There is also a device from, I think, Blackmagic that supports just four inputs and one output, or four inputs and four outputs, that also has a MultiView output. But it's just a really nice to have, not something I really need, but yeah. So I think we are going to keep it there unless someone has another question about it. A bit short stream, I know, but there's not much more I can do or tell about it right now without having a try myself first. Okay, so I think that's going to be it. Thanks for watching, and yeah, hopefully see you next time. Bye.